Three, two, one. And liftoff of the Falcon 9 and DART on NASA's first planetary defense test to intentionally crash into an asteroid.
Earth has been hit by asteroids for billions of years. This has happened before, it will happen again. We are talking about devastation that would go for tens to 100 plus miles. The point of the mission is to be able to protect our planet in the future.
DART got started about 10 years ago with an idea of using a binary asteroid couple and testing a kinetic impactor. A kinetic impactor is a technique that would basically be slamming into an asteroid and changing its path so it would miss Earth. People have been thinking about this approach for a long period of time, but there wasn't really a good way of testing it safely, right? Because if you hit a near-Earth asteroid and you deflect it in a bad way, maybe it'll come around and smack the Earth. So DART was going to go to two asteroids and see if it can hit one and change the orbit around the larger asteroid.
The double asteroid system, Didymos and Dimorphos, was an ideal target. We knew there were two asteroids there, and it was really well characterized, and we knew the smaller one, named Dimorphos, ran around the larger one, named Didymos. And that's really important, because you want to understand the system before you impacted it to know what the impact actually did. The way that DART's autonomous navigation worked was DART had one instrument on it called Draco, and that camera was the same one as if you watched the broadcast. It was sending the images back to Earth once per second. And the spacecraft then was going through those images at the same time that they're being acquired and identifying which one's Didymos, which one's Dimorphos.
We trained it to recognize the objects that it needed to impact. It actually would perform maneuvers by itself. It would process the data coming in from both stars, the asteroid targets. It should be able to decide which asteroid is the right one and actually impact the right asteroid.
Three, two, one.
After the impact, the ground telescopes all over the world on every single continent spent a lot of time observing the impact and actually the evolution of what happened after the impact. We created what looked like a giant comet that has a huge tail, and that was all the ejecta.
10 million kilograms of ejecta is the estimate for how much we blasted off this asteroid. And what we found is that ejecta is an extra recoil effect, so we actually even deflected the asteroid more than just what the kinetic impactor brought in itself. It means that you could maybe push it further. You could not need as much lead time in order for this to work. That makes this a really promising technique to use for future scenarios.
DART was successful, so what does it tell to the world? Well, I think it proves that we are ready.
The long-term impacts from DART's success, I think, are really exciting because it's taken planetary defense, the ability to deflect asteroids, from the things of Hollywood blockbusters, of science fiction, into reality. We now live in a world where humanity has deflected an asteroid for the first time. This has been such a team effort. This started at APL in 2015. People have worked on it for years, hundreds of people here at the Johns Hopkins Applied Physics Lab, even more people across the United States, and then our international partners around the world. And just to be honored and recognized like this really means a lot.
The DART team is very humbled and proud to receive the Michael Collins Trophy for Current Achievement. We worked very hard as a team, and so it's wonderful to see that the world recognizes this achievement.